After a new sale in, you're effectively creating an accounts receivable. And there are several things you can do here at this point in time. You can take a quote and turn that quote into an invoice directly. Like I said earlier, it will pull all your quote information in there. That does not mean you can't change the quote amount on the actual invoice to a different amount. You certainly can do that. You can also, what's interesting here is you can start an invoice, and at this point in time you could say, well, I already have an invoice set up as a recurring, so I can click on the recurring button down here at the bottom of the screen, and I can see if I already have one set up for this particular customer. I could use that. And then what that does is it automatically populates the account number information for my revenue, the amount, the next invoice number in line, system generated in this case, and today's date, which of course the customer address for you, salesperson, a particular comment you might want, the shipping type, promise date, journal memo, whether or not it's going to sit in a queue to be printed, or if we want to print it now, we can choose to print it now. Whether it's sales tax exempt or not, or what particular sales code is here for this particular sales tax. If you are receiving money today, such as a deposit or a partial payment, not a deposit rather, a partial payment on this invoice, you would put it in paid today. And so it effectively reduces your accounts payable by the amount that you receive today, say $50. And if a payment method may be a check, and then it would show correctly my balance due of $200. Now, the details for that are such that if I was using the technique of grouping with other undeposited funds, it would sit in the undeposited funds account to be deposited with other checks that I may receive, or I could deposit it directly to the checking account depending on my cash receipt method. Also, if I have categories set up, I could select a particular category here to use if that was a requirement. From here, once I post this invoice, it will effectively hit my accounts receivable and it will increase my accounts receivable. At this stage, because I used a recurring entry, I would record it. Now, that would by no means affect the initial recurring entry, and it would still have that recurring entry as my template. Should I choose to use it again, it would still have the same dollar amount in there, and it would have all the other information, even though I changed it on the last invoice that I created with that template. So none of this will change here. If I wanted to change a particular template, I would go to another area of the program setup, and I would say, where are my templates? I would have to go to my lists, find recurring transactions, and I could do it by transaction name, type frequency, or search by transaction name, amount, or next due. Now, I know I did it for Caroline Industries, so if I wanted to change the particular template, say I didn't want $250 a month, I wanted $350 a month, I could change the recurring transaction itself, the template, and just hit save. Now that would allow me next time when I go in to enter sales to use a recurring for Carolina Industries and have the new $350 amount show up. So I want to clearly differentiate. There's a template for a recurring entry, and then once you access that recurring entry, and you hit record, you're actually producing a sale. You need to be cautious when you're updating a recurring template. Now, once I've recorded that sale, I can print or email an invoice to a customer. So here's to be printed. So if I had selected to be printed in my actual invoice, it would allow me to print any of these or all of them at one time and mail them. Now, if I wanted to email it, certainly I could say, this is a sale service, and I would be able to put in my email address here, okay? And I would certainly select a particular invoice. And if I wanted to select this one here, for instance, Sienna Construction, if I wanted to choose email 1, emails will be set up for Sienna Construction, and that would populate this field here. And then I, of course, would want to leave a particular message in here for that particular email, and then I would send it. Now, there are various email defaults for the different modules, say purchases or sales and whatnot, and you can modify this any way you want. For instance, if you wanted to have a message in here that's a global message, this would always appear, and you could include or not include the invoice number in the subject, the quote number, or the quote number down here, or the order number rather, in the subject.